Hello and welcome to Qlik Spotlight, and this is a spotlight and I'm in sunny Boston. It is sunny, it's a bit chilly, and we've got a very exciting point to talk about now. And I've got Paul Barth here. Welcome, Paul. Thank you for another spotlight.
Thanks, and John, for having me.
We just had the town hall and mentioned during the town hall in the Boston office that we've got a shiny brand new patent. Can you show everyone show everyone the patent?
I was very proud to hold this up. This is a patent for the data catalyst technology.
Excellent, excellent. So tell me, because it's not just as easy as rocking up to the patent office and saying, I want a patent, is it? So tell me about the process. How do you get a patent?
So it turns out it starts with a great idea, right? Yeah. And something that really has never been done before. So 5.5 years ago when we were starting Podium Data, the predecessor to QDC, my five co-founders and I were working together on a novel way of using new technology to manage data and to help companies get more efficiency and control over moving their data into data lakes and new and big data technologies while protecting that data and making sure it's ready for the enterprise. So we worked out a new approach to this that we called metadata driven. And so, in fact, the patent's title is Data Management Using a Metadata Repository.
Right.
And what is important when you're inventing these new technologies is you want to have a competitive advantage.
Yeah, of course.
And
yeah.
So you define this, you work on your technology, but if you've really developed something new, you want to patent it. You want to make sure you're protected in case a competitor comes up with something similar and claims they invented it and wants to prevent you from using your own product, and also to allow you to keep innovating on top of it. As you said, it's not a quick process.
No. So 4 years, were you saying?
Yes, it took 4 years in all. And we worked with a lawyer who specializes in this. Our, you know, one of the co-founders, Steve Richards, had worked with David Judson before. He's an absolutely national expert in the whole process. And we drafted and worked very hard on what was unique about this process because it's not...
That's quite difficult, I would have thought, isn't
it? It's very hard
because totally unique. Yeah.
And it's not the code that you have. It's the process that you're patenting. You're saying this is a new way of doing something.
Yeah.
And it can't be obvious to the average practitioner or even a skilled practitioner. And it's not a copyright. Like, code is copyrighted.
No.
Right?
Okay.
So this is saying... Anybody who uses a process very, very similar to this is basically using the intellectual property that we created. So as we built it out, he helped us identify 20 different claims of uniqueness around features and functionality that having a metadata catalog enabled us to process data in a new way, more reliable way, more efficient way, more scalable way. And we submitted it to the patent office. And as you would think, many government offices are backed up. So we hear a year later that the patent officer had reviewed it and found that there were some deficiencies, wanted some clarifications. And we responded. Another 6 months went by. They said, no, we're rejecting the patent. It overlaps too much with this, this, and this. Our expert lawyer came back and said, no, it doesn't. And let's get through into the weeds. They got into the weeds. And they did find that ultimately the combination of capabilities and the process in which we onboarded and worked with data automatically was indeed unique. And that led to them reviewing their decision, reversing their decision to rule in favor of us, eventually getting back to us and issuing the patent last week.
Fantastic. So what does this mean to us then? Does it just mean we can go after anyone who tries to do something similar? Is there any monetary value around this? What is it for?
Well, certainly at scale, patents are an important part of any technology's company IP, right?
And, of course,
Fortunately, Qlik has many patents. And in fact, Mike Capone announced today that in the last 2 months, Qlik has been awarded five patents. We're just one of them. And so the teams are busy out innovating. And there's two, I think, important factors here. One is... patents indicate investment in innovation.
That implies
leadership. And I think there's important value in our brand and in the marketplace overall valuation in companies that innovate. As companies grow their patent portfolios, they actually become an economic vehicle. The last thing that anybody wants to do, however, is get involved in patent litigation.
Yeah, of course. That's kind of,
you know, one of the questions at the town hall was, oh, are we going to go sue our competitors? And while it's legally possible, because I know our competitors don't have this patent, that's not really what our business is about. Our business is about innovation and bringing those innovations and to our customers,
yeah,
and yielding the value that we get in the market.
So would you use it as part of the sales process? Would you go into someone and say, look, we've got a patented technology that we're using, and it gives you a bit of extra kudos?
I think the kudos do come from innovation. I think something that Qlik in particular has worked on over the last 5 years is not being perceived as just a BI tool, a visualization tool. Mm. Well, to prove that, you have to come in front of the customers with things like InsightBot. Mm. You have to show them the next generation. You have to show them big data processing. You have to show them, of course, all of our Attunity and data integration capabilities that, frankly, I've been in many meetings with senior executives that say, wow, I didn't know that Qlik was going so aggressively to dominate the space.
Yeah, and it's that cohesiveness as well. We talk about the, you know, the Podium acquisition, Attunity acquisition. They all seem to fit very nicely into what we do. But you've got to glue them together, haven't you? And that's the important part.
Yes.
I was speaking to Brendan Grady earlier about the fact that, you know, with the SaaS and the cloud and making sure that everything is end-to-end and seamless in that way.
Yeah.
So we can have patents, but we really need that glue that's going to stick
it all
together.
The patents aren't an individual capability that's unique in the marketplace, this new kind of process. The great thing about being in one company that's as financially strong as Qlik is we can make those investments in a seamless and very, very competitive differentiator so that the BI tools or the AI tools that are out there that don't have a data capability will end up shouldering, their customers are going to shoulder a high integration cost. And those integrations are often really fragile. Mm. And that, just coming back to the patent itself, the idea that the metadata catalog, the catalog of where your data is and what processes and what people can use it, was in one place, one brain, was actually very disruptive, because what we were able to build at Podium and now QDC was an ability for someone to log in and do an entire data management process from bringing in raw data, to understanding it, to refining it and making it ready for usage, to literally publishing it out in minutes, and that often would take an IT shop weeks or months to glue that together, and it was very fragile. If one product upgrade didn't work quite right, everything fell apart. So this is revolutionary, and we're seeing more and more of this integration down the road with the new products we have.
Well, that's fantastic. Well, thank you, Paul. And this is brilliant that we're doing this. And actually, do we have any more in the pipeline? I know you probably, if it's a patent, you can't really talk about it, because otherwise everyone will be stealing it.
Exactly. Well, I will say that in our role here, we haven't been working on, we have a couple of things that we may be considering for patent.
Yeah.
And we're doing that in collaboration with Elif and her team.
That's actually
a really good note, which is we're actively working right now on integration with the cognitive engine. Because you have an intelligent engine there, and we have a lot of information about the data assets that are available, who's been using them, how they've been used, both inside of QlikSense and in other products and non-Qlik products.
Yeah.
So this is kind of expanding the universe of raw data that she can mine to tell her users, hey, you might want to look at this data set.
That's amazing.
So I think there's a lot of innovation to come.
It's going to be good. And we've got Qlik World coming up, and I'm sure there'll be lots of stuff, and we can talk about air patent during Qlik World, hopefully. And Paul, as always, it's an absolute pleasure. Thank you so much,
John,
for talking to me.
Thank you so much.
See you soon again. Take care.
Okay.